And as we told you last week, EWTN is launching a news service in August dedicated to reporting from Africa. In the last 40 years, the number of Catholics on the continent grew by 238%. Tonight, we look at Ghana. The West African country has about 3 million Catholics. This footage was taken from a mass last month in the country's Holy Spirit Cathedral in the capital of Accra. Our next guest works for the Archdiocese of Accra. Augustus Aikins is in Rome on behalf of the Archdiocese and joins us now. Augustus, welcome to our broadcast.
Thank you so much, Lauren. How are you doing?
I'm good. The Catholic Church in Africa is growing and has been growing at a phenomenal rate in the last 40 years. What are the biggest challenges that the church faces in Ghana?
Okay, so the biggest challenges the church faces in Ghana has to do with Pentecostalism, where we have a lot of Pentecostal and charismatic churches swaying a lot of Catholic faithfuls with their prophecies and then their promise of heaven here on earth. The second one has to do with priests. We don't have a lot of priests. For some time now, we've seen the growth, but we still need more priests to be able to solve this issue so that we'll have interaction with our priests one-on-one. And then the third one has to do with the violence we have. Some parts of Africa has a lot of violence, others also don't. So this, I would mention these three as some of the challenges we are facing.
During the past two synods in Rome, the bishops from Africa have been quite vocal about the needs and the concerns of the church in Africa. Are they being heard? Are things changing? Are some needs now being met?
Yeah, I would say that yes, we sometimes feel that, I don't know, on a scale to 1 to 10, 10 being the highest, I would say that our bishops have only 4% or 4, they are not being heard as much as they should, because issues in Africa would be different from issues in US, as well as different in other parts of the continent. So if they are listened to more, I think some of the challenges I mentioned earlier on could be solved.
This past Sunday in Burkina Faso, we reported that a gunman killed a priest and five worshipers during mass. Burkina Faso is just north of Ghana. These attacks most likely were by Islamic extremists. How concerned about the safety of Catholics are you, especially those in Ghana and Burkina Faso?
Let me say that I am in the southern part, but I have interactions with my other friends in the northern part of Ghana. And let me say that there's peace within Ghana between the Christians and the Muslim community. We enjoy peace. We are one together. Recently, let me make mention of this. My Archbishop, who was took canonical possession of my Archdiocese of Accra just some few months ago on the 1st of March, paid a courtesy call to the chief imam as well as the head of the Ahmadiyya mission in Ghana. So when it comes to the Christians or the Catholic Church and the Islamic community, we are living together as one people. It's unfortunate that with the incident which happened in Burkina Faso, let me say that this won't happen in Ghana because of the level of peace we have enjoyed.
Augustus Aikins from the Archdiocese of Accra in Ghana, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much, Lauren.